as we saw in the previous lesson, we were looking at the line of best fit, and it was really quite difficult to draw it by hand and to draw it accurately. But there is a better way of doing it. So greater accuracy can be achieved by drawing a line of best fit, which is in the form of y equals mx plus c or b, or whatever we're used to seeing. Okay, so the best way of doing this is this thing called the least squares regression line of best fit. And this is used when the data shows a linear relationship, and it can even be used when our data actually has some outliers as well. Now, the least squares regression equation minimizes the average deviation of the points in the data set from the line of best fit. Now, all this is a whole lot of words, but the thing is, you actually have to know how to do this. This is in or on your formula sheet, and you have to know what it looks like. So in this purple box here, this is what is on your formula sheet, where x bar is the mean of the independent variable, which is your x variable. Y is the mean of your dependent variable, which is your y variable. Sigma x, where we know sigma stands for standard deviation, so it's the standard deviation of your x values. Sigma y is the standard deviation of your y values. And r is the new thing we learnt before, which is a correlation coefficient. Now, in doing this work that I'm going to show you now, I would really like you to have this formula in front of you to keep referring back to. So let's have a look at the one example that I've put on here. And here is an example. The data in the table gives the average height, h in centimetres, of 17-year-old girls for the years 1850 to 1990. The time t is measured in years since 1850. So, here I have two variables. I've got time and height. The first one is always your x value, and the y one is your second value, all the time. So when I go to draw this now, because the first thing says to draw a scatter plot, I'm going to put my scatter plot up here and think about the things I'm going to need. So I'm going to need time along the bottom, and I'm going to need height along my y-axis. I'm going to determine a scale, so I think really every 20 is going to work. 20, 40, 60, and so on. And on my y-axis, I'm just going to draw my little hash to say I'm not starting at the beginning, and I'm going to start at 140. So I'm going to do 140, 150, and I'm going to put a title. So through the marvels of time-lapse video, I've now drawn my scatter plot. I've got time along the bottom, I've got height. I should have really put a title, which I haven't done, so you can do that. Average height of 17-year-old girls from 1850 to 1990. I've drawn my scatter plot, I've put in my line of best fit, which looks as best as I can. Okay, now, the things that we need to do now. It says calculate the mean and standard deviation of time and height, and given your correlation coefficient, calculate the equation of the least squares line of best fit. So we're going to have a look at doing this. So you're going to need your formula in front of you, plus the information from this graph, plus a calculator so you know what's going on. So I'm going to bring my calculator up now, and I'm going to clear it. So we're going to be doing the same thing as when we set up for finding the correlation coefficient. So we're going to press mode, and we're doing statistics. And we're doing statistics, and we need our two variable, so two, because we need our x and y. Now I'm putting our x values in. We know we want 0, and we press equals. And then we've got 20, and then we've got 40, 60, and so on and so on. And once we've done that, we go over and we do the other side, and we've got for the first y value is 147, which is our height, and then we've got 149, and so on and so on. So this is exactly what we've done before. I've now put all the numbers in, and you can see I've got 8 scores, so I know that I am on the right track. I've got my x values, I've got my y values. My x values are the time in years in this case, and my y value is the height. So now what I'm going to do is I'm going to press clear, and I'm going to go shift 1 for statistics, and I'm going to go back to our normal 1 for, which is variables, And now if you look in here, you can see I have sigma x, I've got y bar, I've got x bar, and I've got sigma y. So I've got my y mean, I've got my standard deviation mean, I've got my x mean, which is my time, and I've got my standard deviation. And these are the numbers that we're going to need in order to use that formula. Because that formula needs to have our x bar and y bar and all of these other things like that. So let's have a look at writing those down. So once we've done that, we can just press 2 and press equals, and you can see that the mean of the x values is 70. We can press clear again, so shift 1, we've got to go through it every single time. We can do our standard deviation 3, and I get 45.8. Let's just leave it to one decimal place, and we do the same, shift 1, 4, and then we need to get our y value, so the y mean is 158, and so on and so on. So now I'm going to write these down. So I've now written down all this that my calculator gave me. And the reason I've done this is that, actually part of it, is that the question asked me to do this. The question said, calculate the mean standard deviation of time and height. And that's what I've done here. And I could probably put down next to that that this was the time, and so on and so on and so on. Now, the point of all of this is you have to use a formula which is on your formula sheet. And here it is. Here's a formula, y equals a gradient, mx, plus the y-intercept, b or c, or whatever we want to call it. So it's in that form of y equals mx plus b. But we can't just read this off the graph. Now my gradient, m, remember m is my gradient, is the correlation coefficient times by the standard deviation of the y-scores divided by the standard deviation of the x-scores. So this is what we've gotten from our calculator, and we've also got this number from our calculator. And then to find our y-intercept, or our b, it's the mean of the y-scores minus your gradient number, which you get from this formula, this one here, goes here, times by the mean of your x-scores. So you need to understand what this formula is saying to you and how to use it. So keep this formula in front of you and let's have a go at answering the next part of this question. So, thinking about the formula, the very first thing that we have to find is we have to find the gradient. So the gradient, I'm just going to write the word gradient, and we're going to substitute our numbers into this gradient formula. So the first thing the gradient says is I need to use my correlation coefficient. Now the question gives me the correlation coefficient, R. It says R is 0.983. And your calculator could have also given that to you as well. So if I brought my calculator back up, in here, shift 1, 4 even. No, it doesn't give it to me in there. Shift 1, I should say, 5 for regression, press 3 for correlation. And there it is here, that correlation coefficient, just the same way as we found it before. So let's have a look at finding my gradient. So my gradient is the correlation coefficient, which we know from the question and also if I was looking at it in my calculator, is 0.983. And we times that by the standard deviation of the y-scores, which is 7.1, over the standard deviation of the x-scores, which in our case is 45.8. And when we work this out, we get a number which is 0.152. And that's the first thing we need to do. Now the next part of the formula says we need to find the y-intercept. So let's find our y-intercept. So in order to find our y-intercept, we need the mean of all the y-scores, which is 150, I'm pretty sure it's actually 158, I think I've written that down incorrectly, and my pen hasn't come out, so 158 minus the gradient, which we worked out from the question above, which is 0.152, times by the mean of the x scores, which is 70. And I'll put that in brackets because it's in brackets on the formula sheet. And so we can work that out in our calculator, and we get 147.36. And the question is asking me then, well, what is the formula? Well, the formula is y equals the gradient, which is 0.152, y equals mx plus, normally we have y equals mx plus b, b being the y-intercept, so in this case 147.36. And there we have the equation of the line of best fit, or the least squares regression line. At looks like a lot of work, so I'd like you to watch the video again. Check out that you can do the calculator. Write down the calculator steps if you need them. And I will see you in the next video to show you an even easier way of using your calculator to get this.